The fool had fallen for it. Pride was his weakness and his deadly sin. Plus, he fell prey to the temptation to do some important research, to prove once and for all that he was worthy of calling himself an academic. But then Sir Elian the White had played his final trick on Oliver Ruggles, who did not deserve the Templar name of Sir Bedivere. He said he had to ensure he was who he said he was. Because it was an emergency, Sir Bedivere needed to show his signet ring, something a Templar should only do when it was absolutely necessary, and then only to identify himself to a fellow knight. To gain his trust, Sir Elian the White showed him his own ring. Ruggles fetched his ring from a secret compartment inside his dresser, showed it to him, and Sir Elian the White ran him through with his sword. It had all worked perfectly, except for one thing. In the same hiding place where Ruggles kept his signet ring, he also had a plane ticket to Kirkwall. The man was going to see the record keeper. Damn it! Ruggles had blabbed that he was about to get a valuable book, and must have assumed that the record keeper would want to see it. Had he invited anyone else up to see it? That added a serious threat to his plans. A couple of days later, Sir Elian the White killed Professor Angus Macpherson, known to the secret Templar Brotherhood as Sir Lionel. There was no ruse this time, no trickery. The Scotsman was too intelligent to fall for something like that. Torture was the only way to force the truth out of him, and then Macpherson had done so unwillingly. As Sir Elian the White choked and released, bringing him to the edge of suffocation, he kept asking the professor where he had hidden his signet ring. The man had never broken, but his eyes strayed to a section of his bookshelf. That was all Sir Elian the White needed to know. He ran the professor through, went to that spot on the bookshelf, and found nothing. Clever to the last, Professor Macpherson had tricked him.